Hey Cafe crew, it's Colin Smith here from Photoshop Cafe, and today I'm going to show you how to turn your signature into a watermark for your photos. Now yesterday I did another tutorial which you can check out where I showed you how to make a watermark out of your logo, but today we're going to do a signature. So the first thing you want to do is get a nice big clean white sheet of paper and a pencil. I'm using a 4B pencil here, so it's soft. I want a soft pencil because it creates a nice texture. Then what you want to do is you want to draw your signature on the paper. And make sure it's nice and big, but you know, you can vary it depending on how thick you want it to be. Now I'm using that 4B pencil because it's going to give a nice thick lead and a nice texture. And then what we want to do is we want to take a photograph of it using our mobile device. So take your phone, make sure you're exactly above it, not at an angle. And then that way, fill it up nicely and then snap the photo. Then send yourself an email, send a full res file, open it in your email on your computer with Photoshop, and then we're gonna go through the process now of converting that into a brush that we can reuse all the time to create our watermark. So all I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna press Control L, and that would be Command L on Mac for levels. And this is one of those times where levels is just great. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna drag this little white triangle on the right-hand side in, and that's gonna clean up the white on the paper. You wanna do that until all the detail is gone from the paper. And you can see here now we've got a pretty good signature with the texture, but I want to kind of darken it up a little bit. So grab the black triangle on the left hand side and pull that in and see how we can thicken it. Now you know when you've gone too far, like here it looks a little much, so take it to about there. And you may want to clean up your mids a little bit just by sliding that slider. See how it just gets rid of that yellowing? And we don't care about the edges. All I care about is the area there where the signature is. And just play around until you get it looking about right. I like that. And then we're just going to click OK. Now, all we need to do is just grab our lasso tool and just make a selection around the signature, making sure that you're not getting any of these bad areas like that or that in there. All right, now we're going to convert it to a brush. And we're just going to go up to Edit, Define Brush Preset. And we're gonna create the preset. And you can see the size of the brush there. It's gonna be 2,500 pixels. That's really huge. If you wanted to create a smaller logo, just use image size and you can do it that way. So I'm gonna do a full size and I'm gonna click OK. So now we've created a brush. Now we wanna go into our image here. Here's a photograph that I did from my drone. And I'm gonna put a nice signature watermark on here. So I'm gonna hit the B for brush, or just go down here in the toolbar, grab the brush. Make sure I've got white for the foreground. Now you could sign it with black or white, but in this case, I think white is gonna look really nice. Then we go up here and we're gonna go to the very last one, which is right there. You can see that's it. And we're gonna take a new layer and now we're just gonna move over it. You can see it's really huge there and you can also see the texture. So I'm just gonna hit the left bracket key to make it smaller. Or if it's really huge, what you can do is go up here and just drop the size down to a reasonable level there. And then we can use the bracket keys to make it a little bigger or smaller. I'm gonna make this bigger than I normally would just so we can see it clearly. And then all I'm gonna do is just click once to apply it. And there we go, we've applied that logo and you can see the organic nature of it. Let me just hit the move tool and zoom in a little bit. And see that, you can see the texture there from that Bristol paper. And from the pencil, it creates a very natural, organic looking watermark that you can use. Now, if you want to save this to your Creative Cloud library for use later on, what we need to do is just go to the brushes. And then what you want to do is choose the B just to make the brushes active and choose brush preset, because you can't do it from the regular brushes. You have to do it from a brush preset, and that's it right there. So just open up your library and then just click and drag it into the library, and there we go. We've now got our signature brush available anywhere we like. So there you have it. If you're not a subscriber, hit that subscribe button right now. Become part of the Cafe crew, and you're gonna get a new tutorial every single week. Now, if you like this video, pound that like button into dust. Add a comment, let's get a discussion going. Do you like this kind of idea? Do you watermark your photos, or do you not watermark your photos? I'd love to know what you think about it. And until next time, I'll see you at the cafe.